Hello everyone, welcome to our sixth lecture. This lecture is based on two machine system with negligible losses. In this lecture we'll see cut and try process. The steady state stability limit of a system can be found out by three different ways. First method is cut and try process, second method is Clark diagram, and third is by direct mathematical equation. Okay, so out of that we'll see first cut and try process. Two machine system with negligible losses, that means we are considering generator. Negligible losses means we are not considering the resistances, okay, we are considering only pure reactances in the system. Okay, this is generator connected to the motor, it's connected to the reactances. This is X1, XE and X2. Okay, now we'll see how to find out steady state stability limit of a system using cut and try process. Two machine system with negligible losses, as we have generator and motor, it is connected through a pure reactances, as there is no power loss in the circuit, as we are having only reactances, so there is no power lost in the circuit. So here we can consider only one power angle curve. Here we can consider only one power angle curve. This is del and this is one power angle curve. Can therefore be used to show how the power transmitted from generator to the motor depends upon the angular separation of the rotor of the two machines. Here as I told we are considering the generator. It is connected through reactances system, series reactance system. Generator is connected to the motor. We are considering only the pure reactances. So power is transmitted through generator to power is transmitted from generator to motor through series reactance system. Okay, as pure reactances are there, so no power is lost. Whatever we are sending, it is received by the motor. Okay, so we will consider only one power angle curve. Okay, one power angle curve can therefore be used to show how the power transmitted from generator to motor depends upon the angular separation of the rotors of the two machines or upon the phase differences of the internal voltages and behind the saturated or equivalent synchronous reactances under the condition of constant field current. Here we are assuming that field current remains constant. That means constant terminal voltage we are considering. V1, we are considering constant terminal voltage under the condition of constant field current. So constant internal voltage we are considering. We are considering constant internal voltages. Okay, that means effect of excitation is neglected. We are neglecting the effect of excitation. Okay. Now, the definition of steady state stability is the steady state stability limit of a particular circuit of a power system may be defined as maximum power at the receiving end of the circuit that can be transmitted without loss of synchronism if the load is increased in small step. This is very important. Okay, in steady state stability limit, we are considering low application of load in gradual step. Okay, in gradual step. So we are applying load in small steps. So that's why it is called as steady state. Okay, steady state stability limit, and the system will not lose synchronism in this case. Okay. So steady state stability limit is the maximum power at the receiving end of the circuit that can be transmitted without loss of synchronism. It is, you know, already we have derived this P is equal to E1 into E2 by X into sine of del. Power transmitted from one machine to two machine, E1 internal voltage of machine 1, E2 internal voltage of machine 2, X is the transfer reactance, del is angle by which E1 leads to E2. Now PM is E1 into E2 by X. Here del Okay, if del is equal to 90 degrees, if del is equal to 90 degrees, then this equation becomes P max. Okay, that is E1 into E2 by X. Okay, E1 into E2 by X. If the internal voltages are constant, as I told, we are assuming internal voltages are constant, the maximum power occurs at, if we are assuming internal voltages are constant, then maximum power occurs at del is equal to 90 degrees. Del is equal to 90 degrees. Now, how the power is transmitted from generator to the motor, and how the load is applied in gradual step or in small step, that we'll say. And what happens if we are applying load to the motor at the other end, at the receiving end, what happens to the system, how the system respond, we'll see now. The system is stable at any value of power less than PM, provided del less than 90. That means del less than 90, system will, at del equal to 90, system is stable. That means at del is equal to less than 90, the system will remain stable. Del greater than 90, system will become unstable. If you can see power angle curve, okay, at del is equal to 90 degrees, okay, del is equal to 90 degrees. This is P versus del curve, okay. Suppose that if we are considering generator connected to motor, two machine system with negligible losses, okay. Suppose that the shaft load, we are considering two machine system, suppose that the shaft load on the motor is increased, that means this shaft load is increased, so the mechanical output exceeds the electrical input. Now in this case, this mechanical output of this motor exceeds the electrical input to the motor. So there is a net retarding torque, motor will slow down and thereby increasing del. This will cause del to increase. As del increases, electrical input of the motor increases. Now according to this, our power angle curve, as del increases, P increases. As del increases, electrical input of the motor increases until it equals the mechanical input. So electrical input to the motor increases until it equals the mechanical output. At the same time, electrical output of the generator increases for a while, exceeds the mechanical input. Okay, as this, whatever is the electrical input to the motor, same is the electrical output of generator, because it is lossless system. Whatever we are sending, that is receiving. Okay, so as this electrical input to the motor is increasing, that means electrical output of generator is increasing, while mechanical input to this generator remains constant. So there is net retarding torque on the generator. The frequency drops until it is corrected by the governor action. Now in this case, because of this net retardation torque on generator, frequency drops down. Okay, frequency drop down and it is corrected by the governor action. Okay, here governor action will comes in picture. Okay, until it equals the mechanical governor, it increases the electrical output of generator. Okay, so likewise, now the system is stable at new load, because we have increased the load by small amount. Now this can happen, this fourth step, we will repeat till del is equal to 90 degree. Till del is equal to 90 degree, we will repeat this step. Any further increase in mechanical power of either machine cannot be balanced by corresponding increase in the electrical power. Why? Because after this, del is equal to 90 degree, del increasing but power is decreasing. So the system will lose its synchronism. Synchronism is lost. So here we can conclude a statement that steady state stability limit is evidently reached at del is equal to 90 degree. Okay, so we'll solve problem based on this. Okay, we'll solve find the steady state stability limit of a system consisting of a generator of equivalent reactance 0.6 unit connected to an infinite bus through a series reactance. Okay, generator reactance. Now I'll show. This is generator. Okay, it is connected. Generator reactance Xg, series reactance Xc. It is connected to the infinite bus. So this is our infinite bus. Okay, so this is our Xg. It is the value of this is 0.6. This is X1. This is 1. And this is our Eg. Okay, the steady state stability. Now we have to find out steady state stability limit of this circuit. Okay, the terminal voltage of generator is held at 1.1 per unit. Terminal voltage of generator is held at, this is suppose V1, it is held at 1.1 per unit. And this is at an angle of theta. V2 is at an angle of 0. Now this V2 is equal to E2 as it is a infinite bus. Okay, the theta is the angle between them. Now this problem can be solved as here we don't know theta. So the title of this lecture is itself is a cut and try process. So initially we have to assume different values of theta. Okay, initially we have to assume different values of theta. We'll start from in first case we'll start from theta equal to 30 degrees, then theta equal to 45 degrees, then theta equal to 60 degrees, then theta equal to 75 degrees. Now we'll see what happens with 30 degree, what happens with 45 degrees, what happens 60 degree, what happens with 75 degrees. Okay, before directly going to that, we'll see the vector diagram of this circuit. Okay, vector diagram of this circuit. Okay, this is our E2 is equal to V2. Okay, this is IXE, IX1, and this is our E1. Okay, this is our E1 because this is V1. E1 is equal to V1 plus J I X1. Okay, E1 is equal to V1 plus J I X1. Okay, and E2 is equal to V2. Okay, so here the vector diagram of the circuit can be drawn like this. Okay, now we'll start from first step. This is our first step. I'll give here notation as first, assume theta equal to 30 degrees. The current we can find out, this current we can find out, I current can be find out. This is our V1 minus V2 divided by XE. So it is I is equal to 0.55 plus J 0.05. Okay, circuit of two machine reactors system, the steady state stability limit can be found in this by using, this is our first step, by using theta equal to 30 degrees. Theta equal to, this is our first step. Okay, second step we have to find out E1. We have to find out this E1. Okay, now in this E1, value of E1 we got 1.27 at an angle of 44 degrees. Now this is E1 at an angle of del. So E1 at an angle of del means we got 1.27 at an angle of 44 degrees. So in first case, theta equal to 30 degrees, we got del is equal to 44 degrees. We call del equal to 44 degrees. E1 as 1.27. E1 as 1.27. So we can find out Pmax as E1 into V. E1 into V, V means V2 divided by X. Okay. So E1 is 1.27 into V is 1, V is 1, okay, divide by X. This X1 is I think 1, and XE is, that means this X1 is I think 0.6, okay, generator reactors, okay, while XE is 1.0. So total will be 1.6, so it is divided by 1.6, okay. So this Pmax value you will get in the next slide. Look here. Here you are getting del is equal to 44 degrees. P E1 into E2 by X into sine of del 44 at 44 degrees you got 0.55. okay, this can be also solved by V into I, P is equal to V into I, or it is P is equal to V into I. This is our V and this is our I, so it is 0.55. okay, now P max, as I told, is 1.27 into 1 divided by, so 0.79. so for theta equal to 30 degrees, we got del is equal to 44 degrees. We got del is equal to 44 degrees. Okay, and P max 1, at this case we call it as a 1, for simplicity it is 0.79. okay, 0.7. Now we'll plot this. So this is our first curve. Okay, this is our first curve, roughly, or by smooth hand you have to plot. Okay, at 90 degrees we are having 0.79. okay, 0.79. now at del equal to, this del is equal to 44 degrees, and this we are getting at del is equal to 44 degree, power is 0.55. okay, so like we have plotted A. okay, now B we have to plot. This B here, in for B we have to consider theta equal to 45 degrees. okay, for B we have to consider theta equal to 45 degrees. We have to find out E1, we have to find out del, and we have to find out P and P max. this is our second case. Okay, theta equal to 45 degrees, I, we got this value, then E1 is 1.41 at an angle of 62.5. this is our del. Okay, P is 0.78. now P max is 0.88. so in second case theta equal to 60 degrees, and theta is equal to 45 degrees, you got del as 62.5 degrees. okay, while P max is 0.88. okay, and this P is 0.78. okay, now we'll see how to plot. Okay, now considering as different plane, here curve B, here angle del is, I told, 62.5, and this will be our 0.78. okay, while P max is 0.88, I think, you can check, 0.88. okay, it will be, definitely it will be 0. Let me check. Okay, this is our curve B. So we have plotted this curve B. Now we'll consider next curve C. Theta is equal to 60 degrees. Okay, now we have to find out, we have to do same calculations. Theta equal to 60 degree, we have to do same calculation. This is our point number, we'll consider different plane. Assume theta equal to 60 degrees, we have to find out I, E. Now in this case del is 79.5, we have find out P, then we have to find out P max, it is 1.54, and P max is E1 into V2 divided by X, so it is 0.96. so in third case, what you got, theta is equal to 60 degrees, del is 79.5, del is 79.5 degrees, and P max is 0.96. Now we'll check. Look here, this is C, this is 0.96 Pmax del 79.5, this is 79.5, and this I think I we got at del equal to 79.5. What value of P we are getting? 0.95. Okay, so this is 0.95. Okay, this is 96 and 95, near about same. Okay, now next curve D, where theta will assume as 75 degree. Now let us check. Now I'll use different pane. This is our fourth one. Fourth step, theta is equal to 75 degrees. We calculated I, we have calculated E1. Now in this case, we got del is equal to 90 degree. Del greater than 90. So definitely system will lose its synchronism at this point. So finally we'll consider theta equal to 75 degrees. After theta equal to 75 degree, system will become unstable because del is going above 90. Now we have to plot, we have to find out steady state stability limit of a system. We have to find out steady state stability limit of a system. How can we find out? Okay, again going back to our slide. Okay, we have plotted A, B, C, D. We have plotted all this curve. We have plotted A, we have plotted B, we have plotted C, we have plotted D. Now finally what you have to plot, we have to plot this E curve. Okay, we got this point, third point, and then this point, that last point. Here it is, I think here is 95, okay, and this is, we have calculated this as del is equal to 95 degrees and P is 1.06. So this will be our 1.06. This will be our 1.06. Okay. Now we have to join this point, and we have to draw this E curve joining A, this point. Okay, we have to draw this curve. Okay. Now how to find out steady state stability limit? At del equal to 90 degree. From del 90 degree on that smooth curve, you have to draw a line intersecting on the smooth curve, and at this point you are getting stability limit 1.03. This you have to calculate or you have to draw on graph paper or so that you will get steady state stability limit. Okay. That's it for now. In next lecture, we'll see Clark diagram. Thank you very much.